Hello, everybody, YouTube community. This is the Pouncer Channel, and today I'll do a review of Lucifer, Season 3, Episode 24, the series finale. Well, it starts off with a back at the freaking crime scene. They're all talking. Pierce tells the detective ex-husband to go home because he's over emotional. So he goes home. He's looking at all the stuff he got for, like, he goes to the base, not his home, but he goes to the freaking Lucifer's mom's vessel's home, the one that died. He looks at all the stuff he gave her and be all emotional. He snaps. He smashes this like freaking nice table glass. And then he's looking around. He finds like a bunch of paperwork, and he finds out the vessel of Lucifer's mother was doing a case against freaking Pierce. He's like, oh, I think Pierce kills her. But then it cuts off to basically freaking Lucifer and then the detective talking back and forth, and Lucifer's detective ex-husband walks in, and he's like, I think freaking, this is gonna sound crazy, but I think Pierce killed her. And he's like this, I think he's Cinnamon. They're arresting Cinnamon. And Lucifer's like, I knew you were Cinnamon. And then you see them all talking about, like, the detective, like, what, you didn't tell me? He's like, I told you. Everything I told you, like, I knew the whole time. I told you he was Kanan. I told you he was a bad guy. Yeah, you're trying to ruin me, but you do all this metaphor stuff. You need to tell me straight up. You have a lot of things you're hiding from me. Thinking the detective ex-husband freaked out and tried to attack him. Lucifer basically punks him up and hugs him. He's like, can you calm the fuck down, basically, you know? You don't want me to find out. So they come up with a plan to basically to get him, you know, I guess, cause, and to basically uncover his plans and to punish him for his evil deeds. So, Pierce is making a speech at the police station like this, talking how sad that one of the people who died there, how we need to get this bastard for doing this. And all three people like that, the Lucifer, the detective husband, like, that bastard really killed that her. And he's lying about it to her, and he's a leading investigator, okay? After that, it cuts off to freaking Maze, and Maze wakes up, because she's still covering over the drug she took for like that, for the needle. So she's waking up, she breaks from her sprains, beats shit out of these two guys, no contest, walks up, and he says like 5 or 6 guys, and then cuts off. Okay. After that, it shows freaking Lucifer, the detective, her ex-husband, going to this house to basically, before then, like, going to this house to basically investigate this one guy. Like that. One of the most serious suspects, because he's still trying to play it off like this is the guy that's suspect, because they know the truth, I guess. So they go to the guy's house, and they tell him, okay, we know you're being framed for murder, just help us out with this, we know you did the deal with Cinnamon. And he's like, I don't believe you, I'm going to call my lawyers. If you do that, we can't help you out. Okay, we have this DNA thing, that's not going to prove anything. He's like, well, if you have a gun, where would you hide it? And he's like, okay, I'll hide it over here. And they found the gun, and he's like, you know what? Help me out, and I'll help you out. It's okay, thank you. So he discovers, basically, thinking, his butler, the driver guy, was the guy that fucked him over. And the reason he did that, because I think he helped him. I think Pierce is the one he hit, the motorcycle guy. And Pierce was blackmailing him, so like that's basically where they discovered like this. And like, the guy, like, hey, here's a phone, this is how I contact the guy. I'm sorry. So they did that. After that scene, the detective and the freaking Lucifer all go back to the freaking crib. Lucifer's crib, stop talking about stuff. You see Pierce meet some goonies like this. Like that, like, he's talking to some goonies, like, he's like, hey, I need you to go this way, I need you this way. And, after that scene, you see freaking, detective ex-husband talk to freaking Mendez, a fine, beautiful woman of kindness, like this. She's like, I need you to help me out. She's like, oh, you need a hug, okay. She's like, no, I need you to help me out. But she gives him a hug, like this, and like, they stop talking, and like, she freaks out. She tells Pierce, this is the phone that the guy wants me to look for numbers. Pierce is like, okay. And the whole time I was like, you know, I'm not mad at you, Mendez, because you just try to help a friend out and you think he's going for something like this. So, like, I thought you might be stitching, but I knew your past because you're so damn fine. And you're so innocent, so I'm going to give you a pass like this if you don't really mean what you're doing. So I was like, okay. And then you find out it was all a plan. Because, like, you see pictures like this, I need you to take out that the freaking one guy. Okay? So, thinking the detective ex-husband was laying down, passed out, Boyle Bar was probably drunk, and you see the guy coming with a pistol, but to cap his ass. The detective shows up, pistol to the guy's head, they both, it was a trap, they're all in it, they tie him up, thinking to interrogate his ass, and they think they broke him, because they're thinking, like, Jackson's husband had to kill him, all this, and about dirty cop, and all the bullcrap. You see Lucifer, and thinking the detective, going to meet where Pierce is at, like this. Well, going to meet where he thinks the guy's sister's at, you know? So they're walking over there. They finally detective's ex-husband, and thinking, like, Lopez finally realized it was a trap. Because he has no sister like that. Before it was too late, Pierce walks out like this, and was talking crap. He's like, I'm gonna kill you like this. Thinking, like, detective, it's okay, you can leave. Like, I don't want to hurt you. And, like, basically clean his case how he feels about her. And Lucifer's like, it's over for you. So, like, they have a gun. Or for them, like, Lucifer and the detective have a close, touching moment and a good talk. And he's like, Lucifer, just tell me what is true. No, none of these metaphors. I don't see you as evil. You're a good man. And I love you for who you are, basically. And I kind of think they should kiss for that, but they had a good moment like this before them. But back to this, okay? They're there. They have a discussion like this. And then Pierce has all his guns. They're about to shoot. Lucifer freaks out. His wings seem like covering her up. Bullets hit his wings. Blood's everywhere. And Lucifer's like, no! Fires up away. And the detective's like all like, you know, nauseous like that, and like this, like basically half of your unconscious. He leaves you on top of the building, like this, goes down. They have an epic fight. Lucifer comes in, mocks everybody, just slaughters everybody, just beats the shit out of everybody, kills everybody. And then thinking like, Pierce shoots a whole clip in his chest, and he's like, it's on. He has that knife from the demon, like this, you know. Early on, he found one of the things that is Maze's knives. Maze finds the freaking Lucifer's shrink, passes out, talks to her, has a good emotional breakthrough, blah, blah, blah. Back to this, okay? They have back and forth to talk about this. You know what? I'm going to go through this podcast. All the other episodes, Lucifer and him had a talk like this, and they try to see their trust personality, and you see Pal pisses a bitch, but let's get back to this part. They have a good talk back and forth. Lucifer gets the upper hand, kills his Pierce. He's like, I promise I'll kill you. I'm a devil of my ward. And he's like, the person's like, oh my god, I was supposed to die, but now I'm going to heaven. He's like, you really think you go to hell, you son of a bitch? You're going to hell. You know you deserve hell. He's like, why? I believe everything I did was right. You deep down know killing freaking my mother's vessel was wrong. And that's going to torture you for all eternity in the place you deserve to be. He's smiling. You will never change, Ken. You'll always be a tortured soul. And he grabs freaking Lucifer with his, you too. You'll always be a filthy monster inside. He changes into a demon. He powers up. Pierce dies like this. And then you see the detective walk in. And you see the detective see his face. Because all in all, it's the type of things. Freaking, her ex-husband calls her. And, like, he's like, are you okay? Like, yeah, so I escaped somehow. How? I don't know. And she hangs up like, maybe I always knew. And she's realizing Lucifer is telling the truth the whole time. So back to this plot, my bad. You see her face looking at Lucifer like this. Oh my god, it was really true. You are really the devil like this. She didn't say that, but she looked at that on her face before I was telling you. And it cuts off. You don't see the closure. You see Lucifer like, hey, detective. But you don't see what the detective's comment, her action, or her voice in the action. You see her fidget body. And the thing that really sucks is, well, I can see that. This bitch gave me blue balls. I was going to a strip club and having a fine, beautiful woman pop her ass, especially a Latino woman, Asian girl, pop her ass on you, and then going home and jerking off. This is like a big F you ending, basically. If this was another season coming up, I'd be like, yeah, I can't wait to season 4. But it's over, guys. Like, it's a small chance Netflix would get this, or Hulu, or maybe CW would be a good show for it, like that, or if it gets sci-fi. But that's iffy, you know? We have to rely on the comics. Like, thank God me and this other YouTuber guys get hooked up do some videos about the comics and what could have been. I mean, this show could have been 10 seasons. In the comics, Lucifer literally kills a man like this, and then gets his own universe like this. And his daughter takes his place. It's crazy like this, but hey, maybe the guy we're talking about more about that, talking about what could have been other seasons, the other YouTuber guy, and yeah, have a blessing day, and comment, subscribe, tell me your point of view, and what you thought of the ending of the series like this, and how pissed off you are, how they ended it like this, and just give you blue balls, you know. I was like, fuck, I want more. I was like, come on, you can't just leave me like this, because I have to make my own canon in my head now. Oh yeah, one more thing, let's see. What shows do you think I should review next? Because, like, I'm thinking about reviewing freaking, Supernatural or freaking, like, Gotham. So, yeah. You have a great day, and, yeah. Give me comments and just talk about this stuff like this. Salam.